Hey, everybody, check it out. In the house, live and in person, Chris Turvey from Columbia River Guide Service. How'd you come up with that name? Didn't a lot of people want that name?
I think a lot of people wanted that name, but the name was not taken. And when I started guiding, it was just seemed...
That was a long time ago, too.
It was a long time ago.
So, anyway, Columbia River Guide Service. Anyway, you've seen Chris a bunch of times on the show. And we got that triple hookup on Drano Lake, which I hear about a lot. People come in, you know, so that was pretty cool. And we had some shrimp out that day, right?
Yeah, we did.
So I don't remember the details of that day. I'm lucky to remember tomorrow. But, remember yesterday. I can't even get it straight anymore. But, hey, it's all good. Chris is going to show us his take on rig and coon shrimp, because it just blows me away. You have the same shrimp, and there's 1,000 different ways to rig them and different ways to fish them. And so Chris is going to take a minute and show us what's going on.
So there's, like Justin was saying, there's a lot of different ways to rig coon shrimp on your shrimp spinners. And it's getting more and more popular.
Are those spinning those?
Oh,
we just saw the
it's gonna take a minute to get on the site.
Yeah. No, they're not on the site yet. I mean, they just were delivered. We just got a bunch of spinning gloves, so.
That's good.
Thanks. All right, sorry.
It is. They're in hot demand. The summer season's coming up. So, shrimp spinners, it's not just a spring snook thing. We're finding it's a summer snook thing. It's the coho thing. It'd be rigged behind a 360 flasher, and also sitting on the anchor. In that video you're talking about, we actually got a triple, and two of them were on shrimp spinners, and one of them was on a Brad's kokanee cup plug. And the way that those shrimp were rigged, I'm going to show you, the hooks were a little bit bigger. This is just an example, and I like not real big salmon hooks. Like a lot of people think they're going salmon fishing, they want 3-0s or 4-0s. We want them a little bit smaller, and the reason being is usually when you're running a shrimp spinner, the salmon that's going to eat that is not, it's not a reaction bite. He's going to eat it, and he's gonna try to inhale it. And so when you have bigger hooks, it will restrict the 360 flashers. So basically a 1-0 tandem 1-0s, or you can do a 1-0 with a number 4 treble. And it just seems like those are nice small hooks that will hold big salmon, but also allow your flasher to do its thing. So today we're going to rig them with Washington Coon Shrimp. Very good cure, based out of Longview, Washington. And the way that we are doing it is just simply taking your front toe hook, we call it, grab whatever size, and I get asked that too, what size? Well, you let the fish decide. Do they want a small one or do they want a big one? Sometimes the troll speed will dictate what size bait. And what I mean by that is if you're in a combat terminal fishery where there's not a lot of room to get your 360 to thump, maybe a small bait is going to be better because it's less drag on the flasher.
Or combat terminal fishery. It means Drano.
There's that. Some days small are better because it allows your flasher to work better. So simply, all we're going to do is find a coon shrimp. And what I like to do is I'll squeeze the head a little bit. That head is nice and firm. Most of the baits out of Washington Coon Shrimp are going to be like that. You might occasionally find one where it's squishy. Basically, all I'm doing is I'm looking for, make sure it's firm. I'm going to grab my front toe hook, and I'm just gonna go in the side, and then I'm gonna carefully, without damaging the helmet, which is actually the carapace, poke that hook out like that, right there.
Yeah.
And now I'm gonna lay that other hook just dangling. I'm gonna open that up. Probably be better to show you this side. I'm gonna do a half hitch, and then pull it slowly tight. And now you got it just rigged like that, and it's just dangling. You can put a couple half hitches, but usually just one's fine. Now, the other thing you want to watch out for is you want to make sure you have enough beads that your blade isn't going to interfere with the bait. Because what will happen sometimes is your beads will kind of fall down and you'll lose some of the length. And then also not get too long. But that's it right there. And as far as leader length, get a measurement that works for you. Mine happens to be that right there. That's the leader length I run with. And then instead of tying on a barrel swivel or a bead chain, I'm just simply doing an overhand knot, just kind of looping it like that. And that is it. That's all I'm doing. And as long as you have 30-pound line or bigger, it...
Reconnecting. Oh, it's back.
Oh, are we back? Sorry. Okay. Yeah, so these, on this one here, he's going to show you, this is one that Brad Schoenborn tied up here in the shop, and we've got these available all ready to go.
Yeah, so On this rig, you can see there's a wire. And the wire, there's a lot of different ways you can do it. I'll show you one way that works really well, and then I'll show you my favorite way. So one way to do it is just go in from into the back. Boy, his shrimp are hard. That's good. They're super firm. Yeah. Means they're cured really good.
Yeah, you know, we didn't have shrimp for a few days because Landon got a bad batch, his supplier or something like that.
Yeah.
They weren't firm like that, so we rejected the whole batch.
Gotcha.
Instead of putting them out.
Instead of putting them out there.
So that's good.
So then the other thing is you're just taking your wire and you're just shoving it into the bait like that. And what that does is kind of just keep it on there. The other thing you can do is then put your bait, straighten your bait out and stick the wire in there. And I'll be real honest with you, when I'm fishing coon shrimp, I'm paying attention to both those rigs. Both of these are completely different presentations. Some days they want this bigger spread out bait. Some days they want that little bit curled up bait. But the other way that I like to do them.
Well, that one's gonna have less drag probably.
Should be, yep, should be. Now the way that I really like to do them, I'll show you. Instead of going into the back, I go into the side. And I'm coming out in the side there. And the reason why I come in the side, I'll show you. And then I take the tail, and I pinch the tail off, and I straighten it out. I grab my wire, slide my wire down there. And then I stick my wire in. Let me back up. I bend that wire a little bit. There's a little bit of a bend in that wire. Now when I stick that in the bait, going to put a little natural bend in that. Now I'm even going to take it a step farther. See all them legs? I'm going to pinch those legs off because we don't need them, and it's going to be even more less drag. So now you can see how that bait is off axis.
It's going to spin.
Now you pair that behind a 360.
Right.
It's not always a game changer, but there's a lot of times that is. The biggest thing I like about this is I've been able to get bit. And it actually tugs on the rod and it doesn't take your shrimp off.
Yeah, yeah.
And so there's been a lot of times like, oh, we missed it. And you're just about to reel it up to check your bait, and then another one will grab it. And so that's another really, really good way. And that can actually be done plunking too with a spin glow or anything.
You know, I've been using a straightener, been plunking a little bit, and then wrapping it on with some ghost thread. And that really, I feel like it stays on.
Yeah.
I'm doing everything right except I still haven't caught fish yet this year, dude.
It's been a weird year. It's been tough. We just got done with the Drano season. I'll tell you, it's like, I mean, every day's a learning curve. But that's two ways to run them. There's a lot of different ways with the aid of rubber bands and that kind of stuff. But hope this helps you guys. That's just two ways that I like to do it.
That makes sense, too. And the small hooks. People come in and they always ask me, well, what size hooks? I said, well, some people are big hook guys, and then there's guys like Chris Turvey that are small hook guys. Yeah. And, you know, so.
Well, I've had a lot of debates with that with some of my guide buddies, and I think one of the things for me is I run the Brad's Evolution Breakaway Flasher, and maybe that's how I'm able to get away with such small hooks. But I also think a lot of it is we're fishing Drano Lake. It's a barbed fishery for a species of salmon that is going to be feeding more than your summer Chinook, fall Chinook, and coho. And so a lot of the fish we're catching, thank God we can keep them, because you can see blood coming out of the gills because it just all the way down the gullet.
Yeah.
You get those little hooks in the gill rakers and it seems like they're going to do better. But
All right. Well, awesome. Well, thanks for coming in. And you know, you guys want to try out these spinners that we got in here, just come on in here in the shop, or you can call them. We don't have them on the website because Brad just comes in and puts them together, you know.
Yeah.
They're just random colors, but they look good. They're really cool. And then we do ship the Washington Coon Shrimp. I'll put the link down below. We can't guarantee shipping, you know, especially in the summer, like down to Southern California or something like that. It might be a little sketchy, but we've had really good luck shipping in the Northwest here. So far, so good. But that's been good. We ship a lot of it.
So. That's about it.
All right.